Hey everybody and welcome to this video. I'm Inkslora123. This is going to be a come to the library with me video. Something a bit different. So yeah, I'm just in town and I'm heading to Southend Library and I thought I would take you, yes you, with me. So come on, let's go to the library. So this is Southend Library. Well, it's actually officially called the Forum, but I still call it Southend Library. So also part of the library have the Focal Point Gallery. So there's three art exhibitions in here. Hello, Mr. Pigeon. You're gonna go to the library as well? Gonna get some books. So over here is a little book drop. So when you wanna take your book back and the library's closed, you can just drop it into the book drop. I like the fact they have these different tables with like different themes on them, like certain tables are certain themes. So this one is New Beginnings Are on the Horizon. So these are the books that, you know, kind of go with that theme. This table's all about animal fiction. So what have we got here? A wolf. We've got the cat's pajamas, a dog, penguins. Got the little book sale over here. There's a reception over there. It's like a little mini shop over here. Little random bits and pieces. I love the wrapping paper they do in here, it's so pretty. Look at this fairy wrapping paper. I might have to get this. So adorable. Love that. Pound a sheet. Perfect. I love the big wheel with all the teddy bears on. Some cute teddies and stuff. Look. Aww. Hello. Very, very cute. All the Southend on Sea and Lee on Sea stuff. Really cool. Some old postcards there as well. Da 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 da. The Gruffalo. Got a little seating area over here. So over here, sometimes they do like different art displays. They go on the walls around here. Obviously there's no art display at the moment. Got all the audio books over here. Over here is the reserved items section, which I'm looking for a book that I've got to collect actually. So it'll be over here. Ah, thought I was only collecting one, but two of them are here. So that's good. I've got, it's called Highly Suspicious and Unfairly Cute. And also this is, hold on, Laura Wood's book, her new one. I love her books, by the way. This is The Agency for Scandal. So yeah, they've both come in. Rows and rows of books here. Oh, well, this section is mostly like general fiction. They've still got their Christmas themed books out. I mean, you know, why not? So yeah, these are the books that have been returned from people. That was a great book there, The Hunting Party by Lucy Foley. Love that book. If you're into your thrillers, I really recommend Lucy Foley books. She is great. And there's the guest list over there as well by her. That was good. I love these kind of, you know, ooh la la books. The imagery and then the title, Innocent in Her Enemy's Bed. And over there at the back is a little bookmark lost and found section, which I think is super cute. So obviously people leave their bookmarks here. And yeah, they put them in there, and then obviously you can come and look, see if you can find your lost bookmark. Here's all the large print books around here. And yay, book sale. So prices are, we've got paperbacks 25, hardbacks 50p, children's 25, magazines 10p. I mean, what a blooming bargain. I've had some good books from here, actually. Like, it's so good. And also I do, I sometimes buy books from here, obviously really cheap, and then I put them in the little free library which is around the corner to here. So yeah, I might do that actually. Just gonna select a random book for the little free library. Go with that one there, Margaret Atwood, Surfacing. Don't know what it's about, but there we go, that'll be going in that free little library. Got some magazines here. These magazines are really good for my scrapbooking, just to like cut the pictures out and stuff. So pretty. Got the little quick read section over here if you fancy just a quick read. All the romance, ooh la la, as I call them. Rescued by a Highland soldier. Look at that one. The Spinster's Scandalous Affair. It sounds dramatic. Reunited by a shock pregnancy. What a shock. How to tempt the off-limits billionaire. That sounds good. So we've got historical, more romance this side, the crime books. I do enjoy a bit of crime, I have to say. I like becoming a detective whilst I'm reading. Got adventure books over here. Actually, it's quite a big section of adventure. More crime. The Whispers. Missing Wife or Friends Who Is Telling the Truth. Ooh, Erin Kelly. I really enjoyed her book that I read last. Nice little quiet table over here and chair. Actually, I'd like to sit and read here. This is quite a nice area. Just in a little corner. Over here, this is my fiance Nathan's section, science fiction. He loves reading sci-fi. He's got all his Warhammer books here, Star Wars, Star Trek, other sci-fi. I don't mind sci-fi, but I have to be in a certain mood for it. It's not one of my favorite genres, but I have read a few good sci-fis. Yeah, that's still sci-fi. There's the horror section. So we've got horror here and horror there as well. I do like a bit of horror, I have to say. As long as it's not gory. I don't do gore, but I like kind of spooky, if that makes sense. The shadow people. And over here, we've got quite a few bits, actually. Fantasy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 bits. Sections of fantasy. Do like a bit of fantasy. So horror and fantasy, I would say. Probably up there with my favourite kind of genres. I know Finn's read that, Malice and Valor. So they've got the display. Again, they done this last year. So of course it is Holocaust Memorial Month. And yeah, they always put up this kind of display, which is like a travelling display. And very interesting, but very upsetting as well. I'm Jewish myself, so obviously I do find this quite triggering. But I think it's a great thing that they do this, and hopefully people will actually look at it and learn, you know. So, yeah. Yeah, there it is. It says the travelling exhibition has kindly been donated by the late Vivian H. Barnard and her sister Susan E. Erdman, love in memory of their parents, Sigmund and Betty Erdman, who were survivors of the Holocaust, during which so many members of their family were not so fortunate. And it's Yad Vashem UK Foundation. It's Anne Frank in the middle there. It says on the top of all of them, how was it humanly possible? It just really upsets me. So you've got the toilets over here, the ladies there, the guys' toilets over there. Oh, and in there is the little children's library section. Super cute. I'm not going to film in there, obviously, but yeah, that's where the kids go. My friend Danielle sometimes takes her two little boys, the twins, and she takes them in there. So, yeah. I'm going to go up the stairs now. There are a lot of stairs. It's always a good bit of exercise going up all these stairs. Nearly at the top. Okay. Dior. Table about Dior. Squirrels. Did you know that January the 21st is National Squirrel Appreciation Day? Lots of books about squirrels. Dave Grohl from the, who is he in? Oh, Foo Fighters. And Nirvana, obviously, yeah. So, got a new book section over here. I love the look of that book, but I haven't read the others in the series, so it's kind of pointless, but it's so pretty, isn't it? I love the black and gold. Ryland Clark. He's a character. I'm not really into like autobiographies and stuff, but I reckon his one would be quite funny. This is the YA section. Look at all these beautiful Mortal Instrument books. My favourite series of all time, Cassandra Clare. Mortal Instruments. I've got all of them. I own every single one of them. Here are some of the newer YA books. Literally finished reading that about a week or so ago. Cursed by Marissa Mayer. It's quite a big YA section here, which is good. I do love a bit of YA, I have to say. This is a book I was really tempted to get. Adrian Young's Saint. It says here, it's a prequel to Fable. I've not read any of the others, so that was kind of what's put me off. But I know it's a piratey vibe. But then, I suppose if I've not read the others, and this is a prequel, I suppose it doesn't really matter, because this happens beforehand. But, I don't know, I've got so many books to read. I've already got so many. Oh, so many books, too little time, huh? Love Robin Talley books. This was amazing. Music from Another World. And there was also The Love Curse of Melody McIntyre. Very good. I just found this book here. This is The Watch That Ends the Night. Voices from the Titanic. It was me saying I'm not going to get any books, but I don't know if this is in verse. Yeah, they're like poems and stuff. The ship rat, follow the food, follow the rats. Scuttle, scuttle, follow the rats. Scuttle, scuttle, follow the food. It's a bit depressing though, isn't it? Because you know what happens in the end, it's a bit like... Got all the manga, or manga, I never know how to say it, over here. This is what Nathan watches. JoJo's Bizarre Adventures. Really cool book covers, actually. Look at that. Over here you've got all the graphic novels. She's very creepy. She has a scary face. And the way that he's holding that cat. I think it's a cat. I don't like this. This is scary.
Superman.
I do like the odd graphic novel. Like, not all the time, but just now and again, I do like reading a graphic novel. Especially like looking at the artwork and stuff. And here's the ladies' toilets, which I'm going to use now. So we've got the biographies sections. There's quite a lot of sections for biographies of different people. Is that Pat Sharp? Rerun the fun, Pat Sharp. Oh, I like her, Catherine Ryan. She's very funny. There are so many biographies. People who just want to, you know, talk about themselves. You know what I mean? I don't know. Autobiographies aren't really my thing. Saying that, I'm actually listening to Prince Harry's audiobook at the moment of Spare. So, but it's more like, I don't know, not like an autobiography, more like memories. I don't know. History USA.
USA, USA.
This is European history. We've got modern history Britain. Got history of Asia, history of the Middle East. This is Europe. I don't know what they're doing out there. I really haven't got a clue. They've been doing this for ages. I don't know if they're making flats or, I've no idea. Maybe it's going to be like a park or something, nice seating area. Who knows? Who knows? I love these old big books. Look at that. Big old books. There's Winston there. Winston Churchill. This is all Second World War history. Ancient history. It's all the First World War. Ancient history. Egyptian history. So the travel section over here. Different countries. These are all travel, I think. Yeah, all travel sections. The maps. Lots of maps. So many maps. Travellers' towels. The towels of travellers. These are the very big, oversized books. They're massive. So big. Bigger than my head. I've got a big head. Look at that one. It's huge. Tropical fish. I wonder if my goldfish Wilma would be in there. Probably not. Some funny humour and satire themed books. This is classical literature. More classical literature. I'd be honest, I don't know any of the classics really. I don't read classics. Maybe I should, but I don't. I love these old looking books. Look at that. They're just, I don't know, they've got personality about them. All the rips and the tears and just, I don't know, I like it. They are, what is it, aesthetically pleasing. Just never heard of any of them, to be fair. Got Shakespeare over here. I've heard of a few, obviously, of the Shakespeare plays and stuff, but I've never read them or anything. I've read retellings of Shakespeare stuff, plays, but I've never read the actual original kind of thing. Got a sports section. This is the section my dad's normally in. Well, one of the sections my dad is in. He loves his sports stuff. Normally West Ham United related. More sport over here, literature. And writing. Oh, I love the cover of that. Steampunk Bible. That's pretty cool. Look at that. But This has got some nice artwork in it. Books about the theatre, dancing. Ooh, quizzes and games. I do like playing quizzes and playing games. Got music artists over here. Oh, John Lennon, absolutely amazing artist. It's his film over here. Walt Disney's Disneyland. This is the photography section. I like the camera artwork. Artists. Now I will say, I enjoy looking at art. I like art. What's that? That caught my eye. She looks like me. Do you not think? Well, I'm doing like a pout. Maybe not, I don't know. It's cool though. This is a nice little book. What's this? Do you know what? I might take this book out. A little secret here. Sometimes me and Nathan will get a book and it's got like an art theme, can be a different artist or a theme or whatever. And we just sit and look through it together and pick our favourite pictures. It's a true story. So I'm going to get this one because I like the artwork in it. And I think he will as well. We can look through that together. Ah, Shirley Hughes. When I was a kid, I used to love reading Shirley Hughes books. If it wasn't such a big, heavy, chunky book, I'd have got that. But I've got to carry it and it's too heavy. It's all about painting. A couple of cats there. Oh, that's a lovely book. Look at that. London. Oh, that is beautiful. Once again, though, probably really heavy for me to carry. I've never been a fan of Banksy stuff. I know it's weird and it's a bit out there and quirky, but I've just never really been a fan. Oh, that's a nice cover. Look at that. Looks like me and Nathan. Do you know, I'm going to get that one as well. That'd be nice to look through with him. Do our little looking through art books together. Textiles. Fashion. Lots of art and crafty sections around here. Needlecraft, making costumes, fashion, graphic design. But my cousin Clive used to do it, actually. There's more craft stuff over here. Reminds me I better get into my scrapbooking. When I bought the scrapbook and loads of stuff to, you know, use it with, and I've not done like one page of my scrapbooking. I need to actually do the scrapbooking now. I've got all the stuff. This is Nathan's kind of area. Coins and medals. He loves reading and like collecting old coins and finding out their like history and stuff, and medals as well. Got over here sculpture, drawing, contemporary art. Some modern art over here. I have to say I prefer old school art than all the modern art, but that's just me. Look at these beautiful old books. So of old books. There we go, representing Essex towns and villages. I'm very proud to be an Essex girl. Still art over here, isn't it? Yeah, all the art stuff. And this is where like the local South End history is, library use only. So I don't think you can take these out, you can only sort of read them within the library, which is, yeah, fair enough. Very obviously old documents and stuff, they can't, and books, they can't risk, you know, getting lost or someone spilling their coffee over them. New housing areas of Southend-on-Sea. Very, very old, some of these. Oh, look, witchcraft. Witchcraft. Grim Essex. Oh my, all the bad stuff of Essex. Essex local history. I'm pleased that there is like a nice big section for, you know, local history and stuff. That sounds a good one. Little Dick the Smuggler. Another East Anglian eccentrics. Little Dick. Little Dick and the Smuggler. There we go. Cool, that's a big old book, isn't it? Thick as you like. They're from the council, I think, yeah. County Borough, Southend-on-Sea. Council committees, meetings and proceedings. Huge. But all part of our history. The yellow pages. Oh my god, I remember them. They got rid of them. And the old phone books. This is like a piece of history. These are the ones I remember. This kind of colouring. But I remember the yellow pages as well. Obviously people just like, if they want a number now, they just look on Google and that's that. But back in the day, we used to use a phone book, you know. Look for a phone book. I think these are all maps, drawers of maps. I do like a nice map, I have to say. Look at that. More old books in this cabinet and paperwork and stuff. It's pretty cool. Look at that. Love old books so much. Yeah, look, there's all, open the drawer and there's all these old maps and stuff. Oh, that's a strong drawer, that. Very heavy. So you can use the computers and stuff. Some little leaflets here. Historic Rochford. I like Rochford, actually. I was actually born in Rochford, believe it or not. I was born in Rochford Hospital. Got some more new book section over here. And like different leaflets and stuffs. I think over here is mainly like non-fiction more so. What's that? Cute. Wild animal friends. Very cute. Very cute. Astronomy visual guide. Quarter Nathan would have loved that. He would have loved that. Hold on, put them there. Hoping they don't fall. Make a big noise. Oh my. Just going to see how heavy this is. Look at that. It's gorgeous. And it's DK as well. He likes DK books. Might give him a call, see if he wants me to get it. Because it's heavy, but it's not like really, really heavy. I could get away with carrying that. I'll give him a call, see if he wants it. So yeah, he does want it. But it is heavier than I thought. Now I've got it with the other books. I'm like, oh, it's actually quite heavy. So what have we got around here? E-commerce marketing. Building. Okay, I'm not going to walk down every single aisle. Small businesses, finance, nice little tables and stuff that you can sit at and read. Some cooking stuff. This guy's everywhere. Old Joe Wicks. Old Nick Knowles as well. It's like food science, food stuff, baby stuff. Transport, like all health, lots of rows of different, you know, illnesses and health advice. Nutrition, you can see all the different subjects, languages and science. Wish I could speak another language, but there we go. There's all cooking books, I think these are cooking books. Empty shelves, nothing on there. These are return books from upstairs. So these are probably going to be like non-fictiony books. Teaching and stuff over here. And there's the computers that you can use for free, which is really good. Criminology, social work. These books are really heavy. This is a bad idea. Banking. Let's go down here. We'll go through the middle. Politics, conflict, I mean, that's a depressing subject. Religion, I like this, all the different faith symbols and stuff, which is cool. And of course that is mine, there we go, Big Star of David there representing. Got this little table over here. This is news and journalism stuff. Got this, not that many books over here. Hold on, let me put this down. A second. Hold on. I do love a bit of paranormal spooky stuff. Oh, the Hunter Files. I watch that on Discovery Plus sometimes, explaining the unexplained. Afterlives of the rich and famous. Oh, maybe she talks to the dead, like celebrities and stuff. Grace Kelly, Chris Farley, Richard Pryor. Oh, Richard Pryor was so funny. Elvis, Clark Gable. I think that's what it is. I think she's a psychic who talks to the dead. I think he died, Colin Fry. I liked him. He was a nice man. Well, I didn't know him, but he seemed nice. I've heard of him. I think he's Scottish, maybe. Mysteries Uncovered. I think Nathan's had that book out before. True Stories of the Paranormal and Unexplained. I think they need more. They need more in this section of supernatural stuff, because I think a lot of people are into this kind of stuff, and there's just not that much. There's not that much here. There is to people. And now, just to finish off this video, I am going to sit down and have a little read. I've come back to my little corner area. So let's get reading. Okay, so I'm going to get my glasses out, which I actually did remember to bring with. Sometimes I come to the library to read and I get there and I'm like, oh, I forgot my glasses. But I have my glasses today, which is good. So get those. How they look. Do I look studious? Anyway, comfortable. I've got to get my book now. So this is my current read, and it's called The Cloisters by Katie Hayes. How beautiful is this cover? Like, seriously, it's amazing. And let me show you. Oh, hold on. There's all like the old tarot cards in here. Look at the artwork on this. It's gorgeous. So yeah, this is from Waterstones, by the way. And I got it yesterday. I started it last night and I'm not that far in. Hold on, where am I? Oh, dropped my bookmark. I'm only on page 44. I have to say, I'm very much enjoying it. It's like a dark academia book to do with like a mysterious tarot card. And yeah, it's cool, let's put it that way. Okay, you can't even see me reading. Hold on. There we go, it's a bit better. Let's do this. Okay, so I'm out of the library now. Really enjoyed it, actually. Very relaxing, calming. There's something so soothing and relaxing about just being in a library, whether it's sitting down reading, walking around looking at the books. It's just very therapeutic for me, being a bookworm. I don't know, but I've always loved and enjoyed being in libraries and found them very relaxing. Ever since I was a little girl, my dad used to take me to Southend Library, which wasn't that one. The old Southend Library is in Victoria Avenue, but it's not a library anymore, it's an art gallery. But yeah, so from childhood, I've always really enjoyed, you know, being around books and stuff. So yeah, it's a big library, the Forum. It's very big and lots of different sections and stuff. And I do get a lot of the new books in there as well, like some books that have just come out, they get them. So yeah, so I picked up my two fiction books, and obviously I've got the two art books to look through in Nathan. And I rang him and he did want that spacey themed DK book, so carrying heavy bags now. But who's gonna carry the books? Me! So I'm gonna end this video actually by walking around to the little free library. I put one up a few months ago outside a local church, and it's really lovely. It's like this little, well, you'll see it, like this little mini library. And basically the rule is you put a book in, you take one, you know. Or, you know, obviously if you haven't got one to give in, don't take one. It's a swapsy. Otherwise, if you just go and take, there'd be no books. And there's, you know, it's a nice little mix in there. Sometimes it's, you know, mainly children's books. Other times it's mainly adults' books. Sometimes there's a real mix. Fiction, non-fiction, etc. So you just never know what you're going to find. You don't know what people put in the... sorry, my hair went in my mouth. What people put in the actual free library. That's always a bit of an exciting gamble. And even if I don't get any, I just like looking in it to see what books are in there. Anyhow, so it's just around the corner here. So I'll show you the free little library. I've got my books put in it as well, haven't I? I've got in the book sale, like 25p. Someone might want to read it. You never know. So even if I don't take a book today, because I don't normally take them, unless there's something I really want, it's just nice to leave another book in the box kind of thing for someone. So yeah, let's go to the free little library. Okay, so just arrived at the free little library. Let's have a look at it first, and then I will open it up, see what's inside. Just by looking quickly, it looks like there's a lot of like kids' books and stuff. I'll have a look in, and then I'll put the book that I got in. Moomins! Love Moomins! Oh my god, that is so cute! Oh, I used to love the Moomins. Oh my god, it's like my childhood. Right here. Oh, that's so adorable. It's in really good condition as well, actually. I might take that, but then bring it back once I've read it. Like, I'm not going to keep it, but it's just too cute not to take. Obviously, I have a book to swap. So we'll be doing that. Remember, it's all about the swapses. What have we got? 10 surprise packages for Swickle Street. What is this? Old MacDonald had a farm. Let me pull that face through. Oh, there we go. Hello. These are quite, like, children bookish. This little chick. Oh, it's like sensory. Look. Touch and feel. Very Hungry Caterpillar's birthday party. Hold on. What's that? Fox socks. Fox's socks. Yeah, lots of like little kiddie books in here. There's Emma Dodd's baby animal collection. Oh, it's so cute. That's so cute. Hold on. I can't get to it otherwise. There we go. We've got here. It looks like Bambi, but I don't think it is Bambi. We've got a fluffy chick. Yeah, so these are mainly, mainly kids books here. Right, so let me put my book in to replace for the Moomins. Right, so Margaret Atwood's Surfacing is going in. Get some adult fiction back in here as well. Normally, as I say, it's, you know, there are some adult books. There we go. Me and the Moomins. I'm very happy about that. Okay, everyone, so that's the end of the video. I hope you've enjoyed watching. Please click like, comment, share, subscribe to my channel. That would be awesome. Don't forget to smash the notification bell to all notifications. And yeah, check out my other channel as well. The link's down below. So it's minxlaura123asmr. And also my social media links are down below. If you care to follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Goodreads, if you're a bookworm like me, TikTok, it's all there down below. So come and follow me and subscribe to my channels and all that jazz. Also, let me know in the comments section if you are a bookworm like me, what book you are currently reading and if you're enjoying it or not. Right, okay, I'll see you all very soon. Take care. Bye.